All right, what is going on, you lovely ladies and gentlemen of the world? I was stuck in a bit in loading hell. I don't know, every once in a while. We're watching replays of King of Fighters 15. And so you're on character one side, you're seeing the girl I'm here for. Ms. Vanessa. I think I have settled on my first team. And it's Luong Vanessa Clark. I almost said Carl for some reason. And so those are the characters that I'm going to be focused on looking at in the replays, who I'm going to be looking for. Damn, we just... Oh my goodness! We're command dashing, baby! That is one thing I'm curious about. I'm glad this person is using command dash as often as they are, because I'm curious how effective they really are in practice, because it feels like it gives her a lot of really dirty options, because she has the command dash, she can go forward or backwards, she has the little sway, which originally I thought was going to be a lot dirtier, because it looks like this player hasn't used it yet, but if you just do the sway and let go of the button immediately, she just instantly stops. So I thought she got like instant recovery, which would give you some really dirty pressure, but there's a teensy little bit of additional recovery at the end. Damn, who is this reminding? It's not reminding me of... Who is this character reminding me of? Akihiko! That's who it is, like, the little... All this stuff... No shot. Just threw it away. Oh, didn't throw it away. Heidern didn't punish. But yeah, like, the sway into, you know, like, sway into move and to sway again. It's really reminiscent of Akihiko from Persona 4 Arena. I wonder if they were in any way, shape, or form influenced by Vanessa with that. Because it really is. It feels very familiar to watch. Because I haven't tried that out myself, so I haven't really noticed, haven't really made that connection. Oh, this Vanessa's good though. Oh, I'm so glad. Dude, this Vanessa. Just get booted out of the air by the stand. I think that was a standing heavy kick. I don't know Andy's moveset perfectly, but yeah, that Vanessa, I like it. That's what I'm hoping. That's the kind of gameplay I'm hoping to see. Obviously, we're day two, so everybody that we watch is not going to be, you know, we're not going to be watching Shaohai. Or like, who Mad KOF I've been watching a bunch. Punko has apparently been streaming this game for like 15 hours a day. Versa, I think, is like another really big name that I've seen a bunch of matches for. Not for King of Fighters 15 yet, but I went on a little bit of a binge like a month ago of just watching a shit ton of King of Fighters 13 sets for no good reason. And so Versa was a name that popped up a bunch during all of that. So don't be expecting that level of gameplay, but... Like, that's definitely the best Vanessa I've seen so far, for sure. That was really cool. I mean, this player is just really good in general. Good patience, good neutral, actually utilizing. Because that's one thing that also I've noticed a lot is people are... A lot of people that are playing this game right now are playing it like Street Fighter, where they either dash forward or they normal jump. They're not using hot pressure. They're almost none of them are using CD, which I can't remember. Is it just called blowback? They're not using their CD moves, which in general tend to give you the most amount of plus frames on block. Not always, but a lot of the time. Yeah, this Kyo, I mean, this whoever this person is on P1 side, they're just really good. I like it. Woo! Oh, missed it. Robert's almost stunned. I just noticed the flashing portrait, but he'll be fine now. It's a big combo. Can't kill with it. It's only 2 meters, but can kill with the next hit if he gets it. Nope. Doesn't block his ankles for long enough. You gotta just keep down backing, bro. But yeah, I'm really happy I saw that one. Saw the Vanessa, but you see, I'm already down a bunch of pages. I realized I was on the wrong scene when I was recording beforehand. Let's not talk about it. Oh, is this the same? Is this the same one, or did it boot? Did another one load in? Another one loaded in. That's awkward. Oh, but I can see. I forgot. Oh, it's not the same one. Wait. So is it the same player? But no, these are the same characters. But so you can see right here, like it says download on the list, right? Like, that's weird. Because it says download on the list, which means technically I haven't downloaded, but that's definitely what I just watched. That's really strange. Yo, this dude using Team Akari? I fuck with it. Two Clarks. And then I really like Yori, I really like Ralph, I really like Leona. I'll never play Leona because she's a charge character, but still I really like Leona. And Cronin pisses me off. Specifically his, like all of his drill moves, if you block them, it just takes so long for the move to like actually run through its entire animation. It's just irritating. So I really dislike that character. Santier. Santier again. Good punish, but didn't have anything locked and loaded. Like, I don't know Leona combos at all, so I couldn't tell you if they actually had any decent options there. That's, oh my god, I keep forgetting to turn this stupid thing off. But yeah, so I apologize for not having more. Like, I haven't streamed this game yet. I have not played a single match, and the reason for that is that I don't know how I did it, but I hurt myself like 8 different ways. And so it's actually really uncomfortable for me to be sitting down right now. And so the prospect of doing that for hours while also playing a fighting game is no thank you. So it's just really bad to, ooh, caught, whatever. I don't know if that was landing recovery on Yori's side. I wasn't paying close enough attention, but caught him. Cut him open with the V. Why does she actually always do V stuff? Is there any significance to that? I don't know anything about the lore. Uh-oh, wait, hang on, let me pause this real quick. My GPU. This is a little bit scary. I don't know why this is happening now. I'm gonna definitely have to look at this. Because I have, like, I mean, you know, I posted that Luan clip. The GPU spiking again. Hang on, let me pause this real quick while this... Like, why is it spiking? It's something to do with OBS. So what else? Hang on, let me try some shit real quick. What if I, like, remove... Let's remove this... Yes. Remove this. Yes. Because I don't know how, if there's any, like... Even though a scene is not currently active, it's still maybe taking up GPU resources. Like, it's still capturing it just to get... So, like, it's keeping it locked and loaded for if I make it visible. And so that takes up resources. But yeah, this is the first time since... I've started playing the game and I've been recording it that I've been having these frame rate issues, and like I've seen the GPU, I'm watching the task manager and I see the GPU spikes. This is the first time this has happened, so I want to know what exactly is causing that and how to make sure it does not continue happening. Because I want this to be running perfectly, I want it to be going smoothly, and I certainly don't want to see GPU spikes in the middle of playing actual matches. Boom, boom, boom. That's big. Super kaboom. I love Ralph. Ralph is definitely... Actually, I think I have Ralph on. So I have two teams, I think, locked and loaded for when I want to play them. I think Ralph is on the second one, but I can't remember 100%. I know Joe is there. I'm pretty sure Ralph is there. And maybe Shermie? No, Yashiro's got to be in there. Yeah, I can't remember. Maybe Ralph is not in that yet. What the hell? Oh, that was... Clark and Ralph looking similar enough, and I thought Clark somehow had, like... hopped underneath. Just didn't look quite right. Oh, too far away. Clark working with a lot of meter, though. You better use it. This dude doesn't know how to play Clark. Which is certainly... Oh, we lived the magic pixel! I mean, he's just gonna get chipped out. But yeah, use it. So right there, it should have used your meter to roll, guard cancel, roll. How dare people not be perfect, not using meter and whatnot. Ooh, Ramon, I'm down to see some Ramon. But ever since I got rid of all that shit, GPU's been fine. Interesting. That's weird. I mean, I'll freely admit, I barely understand how OBS works. As far as I'm aware, as long as you have something not visible, it should deload the entire thing, so it would make no sense for it to be taking up resources. But, like, it's not King of Fighters that's ruining my GPU, it's OBS. So something to do with that. Ooh, we got a lore battle. Hydern versus Leona. Oh, dropping the combo, though. Get rid of that. Yeah, don't do that. That is very unsafe. Very nice. Good combo. Got the EX move. That's the number one thing. Combo-wise. Forget about forget about going into training mode, popping max mode, doing normal command, normal level 1, level 2, level 3, going, holy shit, check out this 100% combo I found on Twitter. Learn which of your character's EX moves gives you, you know, like ground bounces, wall bounces, launches, etc., etc. As far as I can tell so far, my early impression is that that's generally what you want to be using your meter on. Where the hell did he just lost? Oh, he popped max mode. That had to have been accidental. I was about to say, like, this man just lost 2 meter. Where the hell did it go? He popped a raw max mode for some reason. Do the follow-up. Where's the follow-up? Yeah. I'm here for Clark, by the way. Can't be judgmental. It's day two. Maybe, like, day five for some people. Well, I mean, we saw that really sick Vanessa early. Basically, like with Clark. What used to be the charge move, but now it's 2-1-4 punches. That launches. One of his command grabs restands and allows you to combo off of it. I think it actually is the little dive thing that he did. Because you saw, like, he restood Hydered back up, but then he didn't do anything off of it. I'm not sure about, like, Clark's the character I fucked around with the least out of the team that I'm trying to use. That's unfortunate. So, like, I know Vanessa's, I know Luong's, but I'm not 100% sure I need to learn. I need to mess around with Clark's, especially, like, the command grabs and all the follow-ups. Because it seems like some of the command... Ooh, that sucks! Why didn't that land? It seems like some of the follow-ups don't, you can't super cancel them, which is weird. But so I want to be aware of that. Darn. This man put, everything in the Hydern basket. Needs to work some more on Ramon. Was the last guy? Oh, another Leona. People are really liking Leona, I dig it. I understand why. I'm just not willing to try to play her myself. But if you want any if you're here looking for, you know, like, looking for tips, what should I do? I'm new to the game. I've never played King of Fighters before. What should I do? What should I do? Learn movement. Learn movement. I mean, like I said, don't be going into training mode trying to learn, you know, whatever. Yo, let it rock, homie. Should have tried to let it rock when she was just holding up. Catch her in jump startup. Oh, you haven't learned yet. You gotta cancel the second hit. Ralph gonna bring it all the way back? Whoa! No meter, though. Uh-oh. Yo, Leona, fight back! Caught him! Learn your hopping. Learn your, what's it called? It's just called Hyper Hop. I can't remember the specific name, but, like, learn movement. That's the most important thing you can do is this. Oh, this is the same person as before. They were a good player. Oh, and this person's using Luong? And I know people love them some Angel. So we got it. We got to go with this one. Yeah, learn your movement. Like, learn a basic combo. Hit confirm with your character off of lights. Learn a basic hit confirm with that character off of a heavy button. And then learn your movement. Because that movement is going to translate for every character in the game. So learn your fucking movement. How in the world did that hit? It's one of the reasons why I do like Luong, though. She got some big buttons. I am kind of sad, though. I thought Luong was 6'1". I have since learned. I looked it up. She's apparently 5'11", so now I'm not interested anymore. It's the internet meme, right? 5'11 versus 6 foot. She's not 6 feet tall, I don't care. 5'11 is not tall enough. My current celebrity crush is, what's her name? Candace Parker. She's a former WNBA player. She currently works. She works on an ESPN pro. I think it's ESPN. But she's like 6'4". Yeah. It really isn't. Like, watch these and then go watch somebody. Like, I don't know if... I mean, I can go look it up right now, since thankfully this game, Blaze Blue, I can play on windowed borderless and not sacrifice performance. Definitely go looking for players like... Okay, shit, I am sacrificing some performance, apparently. All right. My bad. Don't fuck around with Firefox while the game is going on and I'm recording at the same time. My bad. But look up players like... Yeah, so Xiaohai has... There's footage of Xiaohai on YouTube. Look up him. He's always been one of the best KOF players in the world. Look up player like Punko has been streaming this game a shit ton. Look up Mad KOF, look up Versa. Just find the top players and look at how they're playing versus like the movement of people that are playing this. It's night and day. It's a different universe. Like you were not seeing KOF. And I'm not saying that to disparage these players or try to be like, yo, these players suck. Get good, scrubs. But it's just, you know, these a lot of these people, again, are people that have not played KOF. They're not familiar with KOF. And a shit ton of people are trying to play this game currently like Street Fighter. And this game is not Street Fighter. Like, this game's actually closer to Undernight than it is to Street Fighter. If you're looking for, like, neutral pace and how you should be looking to play. Maybe I should close. Let me check this out real quick. Like, if I just completely close. If I just kill Firefox. I don't want to kill Firefox. Because obviously I need to have Firefox running if I'm streaming. But like if I murder that outright. Let's see if that does anything beneficial for the overall performance of the game. Because yeah, right now I'm in like full blown analysis mode. Same players. Just, you know, like, what are the best, audio... God damn! Rank 29 versus rank 24? How much have these people been playing? They be climbing. I respect the shit out of it. Especially because, like, they don't have... This is the PC version. Oh, actually, I just realized that. I mentioned... Didn't I say earlier something about... Oh, it's a Vanessa. I didn't even notice the players. I just noticed the levels. No early access for PC, right? So these are just, they've been playing the last 2 days. Just non-stop. Have they though? Not to talk too much shit, but this is not the level of play that I would have expected out of level 29 versus level 24. At least not yet. Maybe they're keeping their aces in the hole for later in their teams.
KO! And player one clinches the first round.
I mean, it's one of those things where it's like, they're not bad, but I expected a lot more. But there's also the possibility, like, I mean, why would you pick level 29 and level 24 if you were going to do that? But given it is the PC version, I guarantee you there are going to be people who are going to find a way to modify their ranks without actually playing ranked, stuff like that. Alright, the Kula kind of woke up a bit. But this other part, like, they're really... They just look kind of... brain dead so far. All right, there we go, we got something. Well, we had something. It's that kind of thing. It's the expectations, they have not been shattered. I mean, you go in like you've been seeing nothing but like generally rank 19 I think is the highest I've seen so far, up until 29 versus 24. So you just think, like, oh, damn, these people are going to be sick. Like, they're going to be popping off. They're moving all over the place, doing some nasty setups, neutral reactions, option selects, etc. Like, nah, none of it. They don't look any different. So if these had said, you know, like, level 14 versus level 19 instead of 29 versus 24, I would have just been like, all right, yeah, this is perfectly fine. But since it did say 29 versus 24... People aren't ready for Angel, I don't think. Including the people that are gonna try to play her. Like, I'm not ready for Angel. She has a lot of stuff you gotta, like, right there. She got a lot of stuff you gotta know. Did you know that was an overhead? I didn't. Maybe it's just their Elizabeth. Like, they know how to play the game with Elizabeth and with nobody else. Okay, that was kind of... Okay, that's sick. Okay, that... Okay, all right, Angel. Okay, Angel. Okay, Angel. I apologize for shit-talking. Like, I think both of these play... Like, that's another thing you can kind of expect from people in general. They're going to be focusing on one character more than others. So, I mean, it's not like their Kula was bad in any way, shape, or form. Like, their Kula will blow me up. But that Angel, certainly looking a hell of a lot better in contrast. All right, so who am I not? I haven't really gotten to see a real Luong yet. So, I might. How long have I been? 21 minutes? So, let's scope out this one. So, it does have Benimaru, Yori, Vanessa. Keep forgetting I need to press the button twice. You confirm like 17 times to get through all these menus. And then I'll look for a Luong after this. I haven't really seen a Clark yet either. That does seem to be one kind of downside. Hello? Why? Oh, I'm pressing the wrong button. There are a lot of characters so far, I feel, that aren't being represented that much. So if you are a fan of one of those characters, you're in for a bad time. Oh, kill. Maybe just thought that would kill. Uh-oh. 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 You let the Kula loose. You let the Kula... He just... Oh, no, he didn't. Waking up Matt... Like, at least Matt... If you're gonna wake up mashing something... Okay, just threw it all away at the end there. Tossed away some meter for good measure. But like, if you're gonna mash on wake up, at least mash at DP, because if they try to block, if they try to bait it by blocking, you're just gonna chip them out. Round two. Ready? Go. Man, it's so weird. Like, I have the voices set to 40. And the music set to 25, and just listening to it, I feel like it's the reverse. The music is just so much louder, or not like, it's not substantially louder, but it's a little bit louder when level wise it should be much lower. Damn, a hard call out, but didn't do anything off of it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna... I'd have to lab some Angel just so I know what the hell to do against, like, these kinds of block strings and setups. How in the world did she cross up right there? Like, my mind, I'm gonna be trying to figure that out for the entire rest of this match. It did not look like she should have ended up on the other side. End of the level 2? Empty jump low? Cutting the combo short early? Like, why not just use an EX move? Might, nope. Didn't really get paid for that max mode, did she? About to say, what are you gonna do off of that? I was curious if they had something in the hole. Cause I know that's not safe. That's definitely not safe. Maybe they were hoping for like a chip out or something? I don't know, that was weird. Player two has victory in their sights. I love the crouching light jabs. It's okay. People will learn real pressure eventually. Just not today. Not yet. Woo! All right, let's go. Let's try to find a Luong. Best of luck, Nate. I don't know why she's just. I don't know why she's never been popular. Oops, my bad. Ranked character one. All right, go to the list. Isn't yet. Luong's all the way at the bottom. All right, so rank 4 versus rank 2, probably not. Rank 12, rank 12, these are all the same people. Rank 15, we already saw that one. Oh, they are different. All right. Rank 16, we've seen that one. Fuck. Am I really out of luck? Yeah, I'm out of luck. That's all the Luong replays. Nobody's playing her. Because these are all, they patched the game like a day ago. And so those are all pre-patched, so they're not available anymore. So... Who should I try to look at? I mean, I don't really have a choice, right? It's got to be one of these up here. So I guess just try this one. Let's go for the last set against them since they clearly played a best of three. So this will be the last match. It's 1-1. Oh, I forgot to mention, they do have some nice, just this stuff. They have some nice functionality in there. You can restart the entire match without having to go back to the match menu. You can juggle between rounds, so you can restart just that particular round if you want to, or you can go to the next round or go to the previous round. So it's not quite a rewind button, but it's almost a rewind button. Like in most other replay systems, you can't go back at all. You gotta restart the entire replay. So yeah, so they got some nice stuff going on. We're getting there, it's progress. Plus R still, I think, has the best replay functionality. Because of course it does. Plus R is starting to get the best of everything. I love the Metal Slug dude in the background. Can you juggle off that? It certainly looks like you can probably juggle off that. A lot of moves that are like that when you anti-air. I mean, just using the characters from Team Fatal Fury in general, Andy can do it off of his little, like, spiral arc kick. I don't know what it's actually called. Joe can do it off of his flip kick. And it certainly looked like right there, Terry should be able to juggle off of it. This dude's using his move, his special moves is all of his movement. Just need to be hopping, my guy. Jump around. Ow. I gonna catch? Nope. So yeah, so just in case, if you're sitting out there and you're thinking, damn, I'm intimidated. I'm super scared of King of Fighters. It's an intimidating fighting series. This is number 15? Goddamn. People have been playing this forever. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna get washed. You're good. You are in like company. I know that sounds like shit talk, but it's not shit talk to say new players are new and have a lot to learn. Woo! unfortunately didn't know how to juggle off of it. Boom, that's so strong for Luong. Her blowback, I don't know, I need to learn what the actual move is called. But the CD, oh goodness. Luong's is so good. Especially because you can't special cancel him. So like with Luong, you can do it, cancel into that, cancel into her stance, then cancel the stance. And you get big plus frames if it lands. Oh, see, he actually tried to do it right there, but he got his input crossed up. I mean, Jenny, like, that might be the biggest normal in the game. Kier, what do you think is a bigger normal? Like, the amount of ground her that shit covers is massive. But obviously, I have not played every single character in the game, so I can't commit to that 100%. But, I mean, it just genuinely feels like if you're somewhere, like, within, like, 40% of the screen from her, that move is finding you. Sucks. Elizabeth does have some. I think they're decently difficult. I'm not 100% sure because I haven't. I want to go check. Let's just go scope that out. At the very end, we can remove all of the goodness. I haven't done hers yet. I'm looking at her colors either. Redhead Elizabeth, I fuck with it. Just see if they have any of them. I doubt they do because these trial modes are garbage. But see if they have her juggles. I think they're decently hard. But she can do like 5 or 6 of them in one combo. Imagine they never even use that move. Like the single most important combo move. Oh no, they do use it. Okay, yeah. So, I mean, they kind of, sort of. They show you that it's possible. What did I fuck up? I guess I didn't combo. Not comboing! What's this move, though? That's gonna be annoying. I knew I was gonna fuck that up. Oh, you know, I wonder if it's because I'm not dashing up far enough. I gotta get deep inside Antonov. Quarter circle back. Oops, my bad. Quarter circle back into double quarter circle forward. That's some fucked up stuff. Why I'm resetting it, probably this combo's probably easier in the corner. Just Antonov can't get pushed back. So it just makes that part easier. Just gotta have faster hands. Yeah. once I get there. Actually, I just realized it is kind of annoying that they don't have him do quick get up, just to make this kind of shit easier. Damn, why is that Link so hard? I'll take it. I don't think that hit properly because he was so high up the entire time, but I'll take it. Not gonna complain. She gets a bow and arrow? Why did it look like... From the original angle, it looked like it was about to, like, go through his heart, and then it kind of went, like, through his stomach area? Oops. Oh, it's not done yet. Does that work? I mean, I wonder if it does. It probably works. Let me just watch it real quick. Make sure I don't have to early cancel it. Okay. That missed, really? That's weird. So you can either cancel it instantly, or you can late cancel it, but there is a point. Oh, it looks like you recover. Okay, so you're not canceling it. You either cancel it instantly, which I don't understand why you wouldn't do that. Too late. Or you wait till you recover and then link it. Shit. This is the problem with doing trials when you don't know the character's moves. Don't know when you're supposed to cancel. Okay, so let me watch this bow and arrow thing again. Oh, no, no, it went more or less through where it was supposed to. But why would you shoot? Why would you shoot somebody in that particular part? That makes no damn sense. I have so many complaints about so many characters. And their supers, the animations for them. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. I'm out. Peace.